I'm here today because I need to discuss food stamps, as I am in need of those.
Okay, but let me just get some information from you to start off, and we'll get the process of answering some questions here.
Okay, that's fine with me.
What is your social security number?
Two, five, four, four, five, one, nine, two, four.
And what is your date of birth?
December 10th, 1964. I live at 9707 9707 Belt Road in Charleston, North Carolina. Again, that's 27727. About 14 years.
And how many people live in the home with you?
There are three people who live in my home.
And then are they, how many of them are children?
I myself have three children.
And what are the children's ages?
My oldest name is Gerald, he's 16. My middle child is a girl, she's 14. And my youngest is 10. Excuse me, my youngest is a girl, and she's 8.
And who's the fourth person living in the home?
My husband.
And what is your monthly income? Yes.
My monthly income, so what I make every month? About $100 a month.
And what's the source of that income?
I travel around the community and I clean houses for a living. It's not a continuous job.
And what are your monthly bills for the home?
I have my house payment every month, which is my rent. I have utilities.
That's Do you know the total amount or approximate amount that you pay with rent and utilities?
I would say it's around $500 a month. I also have my electricity bill to pay. And I'm also charged about $50. It just depends. It's hot or cold weather, depending on that. As well as sometimes, you know, the price will be higher if I use more air heat. It varies monthly. For my cell phone bill, I pay about $30 a month.
And is that all the expenses you have for on a monthly basis?
Yeah, I don't think there's anything else. I do have my credit card bill where I owe money, but it's about $20. I do $20 payments monthly. You know, I was sick and I had a lot of bills, so I had to pay them off my credit card.
We need to know some of the expenses just to make sure to see how much you qualify. So with your husband being sick, does he normally work, or is he just out of work for medical reasons right now?
He was laid off. He's waiting because he was at an accident at work where he hurt himself. So as he was waiting for that money to come in, he was laid off of his job.
Okay, Mrs. Paul, have you ever applied for assistance before?
I've never applied for food stamps, no ma'am.
Was there any questions that you had for me?
My only question is, I don't see why I wouldn't apply for food stamps if my husband doesn't have any source of income for us, being that he's been laid off of his job.
Well, and that's where some of this we'll need to calculate and determine how much you will be able to get on a monthly basis and how long the duration of that as well.
Can you tell me if the food stamps are paper or are they on a card? I'm not really sure what they look like.
They look like a debit card that you would normally use, like a bank or credit card. And it's the same type of thing, you just have a specific value per month.
So will it tell me how much is on the card monthly? Will I know?
A lot of times, depending on the store, they might have on the receipt the remaining balance way you would always know after you've completed your purchase for that time you have been shopping.
What do I do if I go over the budget that's on the card? Will there be any kind of restrictions, or will I be able to add more money to it? How does that work exactly?
You can choose to pay either out of pocket for the remaining amount, or just go with however much that is available on the balance. For instance, if your bill totals $70, but you only have $50 remaining, either with the cashier, you can return $20 worth of merchandise, or you can pay that out of your pocket. It's your choice. So we don't want you to feel like you can't buy that food, but you are allowed a certain amount based on your qualifications.
Is there specific food items that I'm not allowed to purchase? For example, if a food is like a specific type of food, am I not allowed to use my food stamp for that? Or does it vary? Is there specific guidelines that I must follow for that?
Typically, they will give you, when you receive, you'll see the card in the mail. And it would give you a list of the foods that you're able to purchase. Items like diapers typically are not included in that, but it would give you a specific list of what type of items that you could purchase as far as produce and dairy, just general merchandise like cereals and different things for meals.
Okay, that's good. So if I need diapers or any of those other necessities, but I can't use them with my food stamps, what do I do to purchase those items?
Well, what we could do is your baby formula would be included. Maybe looking at some of your expenses and with your husband being laid off from medical, we might want to see what other services that you might need to qualify for in regards to that.
Okay. I just feel like I need more information about what I can and cannot buy. I'm worried about those types of necessities.
Well, what we'll do is I will recommend that we have someone look at your husband's medical bills to help you with that, because that's income that you're putting to that where you're not needing to buy other extra things. Family of five living on a $700 a month income, you may be able to apply for supplemental income as well. So what we'll do, oh God.
So I have a child to care for. You know, my husband still has all of his doctor's bills, and money is just really hard right now. So that worries me.
Well, what we'll do, we will have a caseworker assigned to you. And that caseworker will come out in a 6-month period or whatever is necessary with your home situation and review your current situation to make sure that you're able to meet your family's needs.
So, I'm asking you,
well,
can I get food stamps?
Let me
can I even
do a
receive
couple
them?
Quick calculations. I believe you are qualified to receive the food stamps. And with that, it will be mailed to you 4 to 6 weeks. The card will be mailed.
But what do I do in the meantime? I need that now.
Okay. Well, what we'll do is we'll have to put in a request for emergency assistance, and then maybe we can go and follow that up with you tomorrow morning and let you know how much we're approved to give you right away. You are approved for about an additional $300 a month for food stamps.
Okay.
So you'll get your card in the mail 4 to 6 weeks. You'll also get a PIN number 2 days later. So make sure you keep that. That's a secret PIN number you don't want anyone to have. And that will come to you in the mail.
So I'll wait 4 to 6 weeks to receive the food stamps, and then 2 days later I will receive my PIN number. Is that the only two things that I need to know?
Because it's kind of confidential, you don't want in your PIN and your card to come at the same time. If someone sees that in the mail, they can take that and use that, and there's no proof that we have that you did not receive that. So as far as security purposes, you get it 2 days following, so we ensure that you get the card and the PIN separately.
How will I be informed again about my emergency money? If I possibly, excuse me, let me back up. How will I be notified tomorrow about my
what
emergency
we can do
money
is,
possibly taking
I'll
place?
I'll put in the request for the information, and if we can have a caseworker come out and meet you and have them bring that to you as well, and we can bring an interpreter to have them to translate for you as well. So that way you can start to go ahead and purchase some food for you and your family.
Okay. Do you have any questions that you need to ask me?
Actually, we are all set for today. So what I'll do is, like I said, we'll get your caseworker to come out to your home and bring that to you, and then we're all set. Thanks for your time today.
Awesome. Thank you for helping me. It was nice to meet you.